Hello everyone. Today I'll be talking about significant figures. So the most important thing that we need to know is to know how to count the number of significant figures in any given number. So for example, I will give some examples and we will start to count the significant figures. So in this example, maybe this one and in this one. How many significant figures in each? So the first one has 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this one has 4 significant figures. What about the second one? It has leading zeros, right? The leading zeros doesn't count in the significant figures. We count the numbers only, not the leading zeros. So that's 1, 2. So in this one has 2 significant figures. What about the last one? Scientific notations have 1 and 2. So we just count these numbers, not the 10 to the power of 3. So that's 2 significant figures as well. Sorry. All right. So now let's study the rules of significant figures to be able to apply these rules in addition and subtraction. So for addition and subtraction, there is a rule. For multiplication and division, there is another rule. So addition and subtraction, we look at the least number of decimals. And the answer will follow the least number of decimals. However, in multiplication and division, we follow the least number of significant figures. And we will do some examples on this. So let's see this. The first one, it's multiplication, right? Sorry. So the first one, it's multiplication. So let's see. If we will multiply these, we will follow the rule of the least number of significant figures. So let's count the significant figures in each. So in the first one, that's 1, 2, 3, 4. This one has 4 significant figures. What about this one? Has a leading zero, which is, we don't count that. And 1, 2. So this one has 2 significant figures. And in this case, the answer should follow the least number of significant figures, which is 2 significant figures. So if we did a multiplication, what we will get? Get 0.55756. And the answer should follow 2 significant figures, so we will just use these 2. However, the 7 will make the 5 at 6. So the answer will be 0.56, and we'll see this is 2 significant figures, and that will follow the least number of significant figures. However, if we look at the next example, this one, it's addition. So in this case, we will count the decimals, and the answer will follow the least number of decimals. So the first number, we have 1, 2, 3, so this is 3 decimals. And this one, 1, 2, so this one, it's 2 decimals. So the answer should follow the least number of decimals, which is 2, correct? So, and the answer is 1.582. But how many sig figs or decimals I should include? Just 2 decimals. So I will stop here, right? So this will be my answer. And the 5, I'm sorry, this should be 2, not 5. So, and that will make my answer 1.58. It's a 2 decimals. And as we said, that follows the least number of decimals. So let's do this example. This example has a multiplication part and subtraction part. So for the multiplication, we'll follow the rules for multiplication, which is the answer should follow the least number of significant figures. So now let's count the numbers of significant figures. The 14.84 has four significant figures. And the 0.55 has leading zero, which is we don't count the leading zeros. So 5, 5, that's two significant figures. So if we did the multiplication, we should get 8.612. How many significant figures should be in the answer? Two significant figures. That's right. So we will use the 8.1. We'll include the whole number, which is 8.162 minus 8.02, this number. We will include it in the calculation. But for the result, we will consider it's two significant figures only. So we'll consider this as two significant figures. And for this one, how many significant figures? It's three significant figures, right? One, two, three. And how many decimals? This one has one decimal. Why is it one decimal? Because remember, we should consider this as two significant figures. So the number should stop here, right? Correct. So what about this? This one has two decimals. So in this case, if we did the subtraction, the answer should be 0.142. How many decimals we should include? Just one, the least number of decimals. So we will use this part only. So the answer will be 0.1. Thank you so much for watching. Please like the video, subscribe, and send any comment. If you have any questions, just contact me. I will be more than happy to assist you with this. Thank you so much.